In this session, we'll have a detailed explanation about GG deals. So let's start this session. Gates, Glidden deals. Gates, Glidden deals. GG deals should be used in a latch type of attachment like micro motor. Coming to the uses, coronal enlargement, or orifice enlargement in case of posteriors, and in case of incisors it is used to remove lingual shoulder. If you observe a GG drill, it has a handle and a long thin shaft which ends as a flame shaped head. It has a handle, long thin shaft, and ends as a flame shaped head. The advantage of using a GG drill is whenever these GG drills separate, they always separate at this junction. So you can easily remove this part with the help of a tweezer. So retrieval is very easy. Right? Coming to the different numbers of GG drills. GG drills are available in 6 different sizes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Among these 6, 5 and 6 are not at all used, because 5 and 6 are very rarely used because they causes excessive enlargement. They causes excessive enlargement leading to perforations. Whereas number 1 is very delicate and fractures easily. So the most commonly used GG drills are number 2, 3 and 4. You can use a GG number 2 up to middle third, whereas 3 in the coronal third and 4 at the orifice level. I repeat, the 6 different types of GG drills, 5 and 6 are rarely used because it causes excessive enlargement of the canal such that leading to a perforation, whereas GG drill 1 is more prone to fracture since it is very fragile. So most commonly you can use GG 2, 3 and 4. You can use GG drill 2 up to the middle third and 3 up to the coronal third and 4 at the orifice level. Right? Coming to the diameters of different numbers. Coming to the diameters, GG1 has a tip diameter of 0.50 mm, whereas 2 has 0.70, 3 has 0.90,
1.1, 1.3 and 1.5.
If you observe the diameter, the GG1 has 0.50 mm and GG2 has 0.7 mm and 3 has 0.9 mm,
whereas 4 has 1.1 mm, 5 has 1.3 mm and 6 has 1.5 mm.
How to recognize GG1, GG2, GG3, GG4? How to recognize these 6 different types? If you observe on the handle, this is a GG drill handle and long shaft, and it has a head, a flame shaped head. If you observe, GG drill 1 has 1 ring, whereas GG 2 has 2 rings, GG 3 has 3 rings, so on. 6 has 6 rings, right? So you can identify the GG drill numbers based on the number of rings present on the handle of the instrument, right? GG1 has 1 ring, GG2 has 2 rings, GG3 has 3 rings, and 4 has 4 rings, 5 has 5 rings, and GG6 has 6 rings. Coming to the motion of instrumentation, GG drills are always used in a brushing motion. I repeat, GG drills are always used in brushing motion. Brushing motion. That means just a brush. GG drills are always used in a brushing motion. Coming to the cutting action. Cutting action is while withdrawing the GG drill from the canal orifice. Never cut while insertion. This is a molar, lower molar. But suppose this is a lower molar and this is an orifice. Always place the GG drill and move the GG drill towards external surface, and in brushing motion try to remove the dentine from external surface. Place the GG drill in the orifice and move towards the external surface wall. Rotate the GG drill and using the brushing motion try to remove more dentine on the external surface. Why? Because you need to preserve more dentine on the internal surface. This is called as, what is danger area? The distal part of mesial root and the mesial part of distal root are considered as a dangerous area. Why? Because the inner surface of the root has less dentine when compared to the external surface. Always a root canal is closer to the inner surface of the dentine when compared to the external surface. So if you observe the thickness on the external surface, it has more dentine, whereas the inner surface, it has less dentine. So you should always preserve the internal surface of the dentine. You need to cut more dentine on external surface. So this is dangerous area. So while using a Glades Gideon drill, we should be very cautious about the dangerous area. Coming to the speed of instrumentation, you need to use GG drills around 750 to 1000 RPM. I repeat, you need to use GG drill around 750 to 1000 RPM. Always use GG drills only in the straight part of the canal, but never in the curved canal. Over zealous use of GG drills causes coke bottle appearance. That means, consider this is a root canal where the coronal portion is enlarged by GG drill and the rest of the portion of the root canal is enlarged by a rotary files. See, this is the appearance in the coronal third and this is the appearance in the rest of the canal. So this closely resembles the coke bottle appearance. This closely resembles a coke bottle appearance. Right? This is a coronal preparation by GG drills and this is remaining preparation by files and this is the apical foramen. So this is called a coke bottle appearance. So to conclude, GG drills are used to achieve straight line axis. In case of posterior tooth, these are used to enlarge the coronal orifices, and in the anteriors, especially in the incisors, these are used to remove the lingual shoulders of incisors. Coming to the motion of the GG drills should be always used in brushing motion. The cutting action of GG drill is always while withdrawing, never while insertion. You should always use the GG drill away from the danger area such that it prevents the perforation of the root canal. Coming to the different diameters of GG drills, ranging from 0.50 to
1.5 mm.
Coming to the identification of the GG drills, the number of rings present on the handle indicates the number of the GG drill. For suppose there are 2 rings on the handle, it represents GG number 2. For suppose there are 5 rings, it represents GG number 5. Coming to the speed of the instrumentation, speed of instrumentation is around 750 to 1000 RPM. Hope you enjoy the session. In the next session, we are dealing with a piezo remus. Thank you.